SciShow is supported by Brilliant.org, a problem-solving website that teaches you how to think like a scientist. Refreshing glass of cold water. And if you think I'm talking about H2O, then you're right. But I could have just been sipping on heavy water or deuterium oxide, aka D2O, just as easily. Well, not just as easily, it's super expensive and I would have had to like buy it from a lab supply store, but you get my point. Deuterium is a form of hydrogen or isotope with a bonus neutron, which makes it twice as heavy as the regular hydrogen we all know and love. That's why when there's deuterium in water molecules, it's about 10% heavier and we call it heavy water. And one of our Patreon patrons, who goes by the name Cutsup, wanted to know what would happen if you just drank a glass of heavy water. Well, in small amounts, even a glass or two, heavy water is fine. In fact, in combination with an oxygen isotope, it's used in lots of nutrition experiments in humans because it's a useful way to track how much energy you're spending. But don't go filling up all your water bottles with pure deuterium oxide because too much of it will almost definitely kill you. Rats and mice die when about a third of the water in their bodies has deuterium in it. Plants also aren't big fans and will stop growing. This toxicity is related to what's called the kinetic isotope effect. Basically, the extra mass of the isotope slows chemical reactions down, including all of the super important reactions that keep you not dead. In the case of heavy water, the bonds between deuterium and oxygen are stronger than the bonds between hydrogen and oxygen in normal water. That means it takes more energy to break those bonds, which slows everything down. It's not totally clear how much heavy water would do a person in, but experts estimate that anything more than 10% of your total water intake could start causing problems. So a sip is okay, but don't push it. Also, it's not going to help you at all, and it's going to cost extra money. I don't really know why you would do this. Still, there is a form of heavy water you should definitely avoid: tritium oxide, or super heavy water. Instead of hydrogen or deuterium, it contains tritium, an isotope of hydrogen that has two neutrons and is radioactive. Now, as far as radioactive things go, tritiated water is pretty weak. It emits low-energy beta particles, which are a type of electron that can't penetrate skin. But drinking them is another story. There's some evidence that once inside the body, beta particles might even be better at causing cancer than the high-energy gamma rays that come from things like radium. Scientists don't actually have a great sense of how dangerous tritiated water is. They're not just, like, putting it in cups and having people try it, but they assume exposure isn't good. We all come into contact with a tiny amount of it naturally, which isn't a big deal, but because tritiated water is used in nuclear reactors, the real concern is when those reactors leak or if there's an accident. So I'm not recommending you do this, but if you really want to test out some heavy water, just make sure we're talking about deuterium oxide, not tritium oxide, so you don't want to be a dead person. Me, however, I will stick with the stuff that comes out of the water cooler at work, because it's nice and cool and made up of normal things that I understand. If you liked learning about the weird chemistry of heavy water, you probably like getting smart and staying smart. Brilliant.org is a problem-solving website that teaches you how to think like a scientist. Brilliant presents short, conceptual quizzes that supplement what you maybe have learned here on SciShow. A great way to retain information like that is by actively solving problems on Brilliant. Each course guides you through easy and challenging problems with interactive graphics and questions. One course, Physics of the Everyday, teaches you the science of your refrigerator and toilet, atmospheric pressure systems, nuclear reactors, and more. In one lesson, you math your way through estimating what it would take to build a Dyson sphere before our oil reserves run out on Earth. By breaking the problem into bite-sized concepts, thinking clearly through each part, and building up to the stunning conclusion, you better understand the process behind Dyson spheres. If humans keep a keen focus on advancing science and math, anything is possible. 4 million people are already using Brilliant, so join them in sharpening your STEM skills. To support SciShow and learn more about Brilliant, just go to brilliant.org/scishow and sign up for free.